Right, guys, let's have a look at page 19 then. We got part C, which is from the previous question. Remember previous question? Let's just go back to it. Page 18, this tile thing, isn't it? We worked out the tiles for a 20 by 20 grid. We got basically 400 tiles were needed here, and we saw there were half as many black and half as many white, 200 in each, wasn't there, yeah? And that worked out even. And when it was odds, 15 by 15, right, then when it was odd, you see, we had, that's 225 when you've times them together, one less black than white, because you start with a white, all right, and there's an odd number of tiles, so it goes white, black, all the way through, white, black, and then a white at the end, so that makes sense, and here there was an even number of tiles, so basically, once you find the number of tiles, it's going to be the same number of each, isn't there? So can you see that? You can just follow them through, all 400. They're in pairs. There's an even number of them. So if you start with a white and a black, you've got to finish with a black because they're in pairs. So there's 200 of each in this case. Here, there were 225. If you do 15 by 15, 15 times 15 squared. So that's the only question. And how do we work out a square, 15 by 15? Well, 10 15s are 150. Yeah? 5 15s is 75. Now, 5 15s, if you break that down still further if you need to, is 5 10s are 50 and 5 5s are 25. So 50 and 25, 75. So you get the 225 like we said. But because it's an odd number of tiles, in this case here, you start with a white and they're in pairs. The very last tile, the 225th tile, on the bottom right-hand corner, this has to be a white, doesn't it? Because they're in white black pairs. So that's why there was one more white tile than black tile. So it's half and half, but because it's odd, there's a smidge more, so to speak, of the white tiles, because there's one more at the end, yeah? So take one off that, divide it by 2, you get 112, 112, and add one white tile. So that's the pattern, isn't it? Okay, so let's go back to our question then, because I think it's going to generalize this now, isn't it? Find in terms of x the number of black tiles and the number of white tiles needed to form the x tile by x tile pattern when x is an even number. Well, if x is even, you've got x tiles by x tiles in a grid, haven't you? So here's our grid. So, oops, it's supposed to be square. It's got x tiles down here. And along here, it's got x tiles. So there's x rows. Each row contains x tiles. So the number of tiles is x squared tiles in total. Agreed? Now it's an even number of tiles because each row is even and there's an even number of rows as well. So it has to be obviously even, isn't it? X tiles in total. So that total is even. So basically half of these will be white and half will be black, won't they? Because it goes in white-black pairs. So that'll be x squared over 2 and half of these. Yeah? Now let's move down to the odd one. So it's easy now we've thought about the problem. Now, if you look here now, find in terms of y the number of black tiles and the number of white tiles needed to form the y tile by white tile pattern when y is an odd number. So let's go with y as another symbol now. I'm going to draw our picture. We've got y rows of tiles, and each row consists of y tiles as well. So again, we've got y squared tiles, haven't we? But we're told that that first row is odd. And then you've got another row which is odd. So, and you go down, and you've got an odd number of... There's an odd number there, there's an odd number there. But there's two there, which together, those tiles on two rows, like that row, say, and that row, that number of tiles would be even. But because you've got pairs, you can pair up these and another pair here all the way down, and there's going to be one row left at the end, isn't it? And so that's why this last tile, remember what we said with an odd number, that tile, because we started with a white here, this one has to be white as well, doesn't it? And they're in white black pairs as you go along, as you work down your tile rows. So you're going to go along, you're going along, and you're going along, all right, you finish with the white. So there's one more white tile than black tiles. So basically, that's the total number of tiles. That's every tile, isn't it? Take one off, And that's excluding the last tile. Agreed? So basically, the number of black tiles is that half of that. Agreed? Now, the number of white tiles will be that same number. That takes you to the one tile before the last, doesn't it? Yeah? And then you must, to that, you've got to add one more tile. So should we expand the bracket then? This one is y squared over 2 minus a half. If you split the fraction up, this one will be y squared over 2 minus a half plus 1. So that's the number of whites. This is the number of black tiles. I'll go through this again in a second. So this is y squared over 2 minus a half, yeah? Or you could write it like this above here. And the other one is y squared over 2 minus a half. It's plus a half, because it's minus half plus 1. So that's just plus a half, isn't it? Because 1 take half is half. There we are. And when you add them together, let's just add them together. The minus half and the half cancels. Y squared over 2, half of y squared and half of y squared gives you the y squared. So that totals the number of tiles on this floor. So this is a difficult example. So let's just have a look at this. Remember, we did 15 by 15, and we realized that the last tile, it was an odd number of tiles, because 15 by 15 was 225. Well, if you've got an odd number of tiles in a row, and then you've got an odd number of rows, does that give rise to an odd number of tiles? Well, it does. And the reason it does is because that row is odd. You can pair it up with the row underneath, like so, and you can get a pair of rows. That's an even number of tiles, isn't it? Agreed? And there's another pair of rows here, say, for example. There. But basically, because this is an odd number of rows, that's even, even, even so far. You can go down, but you're going to end up with one row left at the end. So all the tiles before were even numbers, so they add up to even. This row is odd. So when you add it on to an even number, an odd number, you'll get an odd total. So this total is odd. If you think about it, you go in pairs, white, black, white, black. So all the pairs are even, and this one will be a black tile here. Yeah? And that's, so the last tile must be an extra white one, just like it was before. So that's why what we did was we said, well, the total number of tiles is that y squared. Take one off, and that gives you the tiles excluding the last tile. Y squared minus 1. Half of them, so we know, are white, and half of them are black. And then, half of them are black, because I wrote the black ones first, and half of them are white. Right? But then you have to add one more tile, because there's an extra white one at the end to this. Then I expanded the bracket, split the fraction up, like 3 plus... I'll just do a simple example of fractions. 3 plus 4 sevenths is 3 sevenths plus 4 sevenths, isn't it? That's how we split a fraction up. Nothing to do with the problem, of course, but that's just how we do. So to split this fraction up, you just, this thing here divided by the thing underneath minus this thing here divided by the thing underneath. That's why I wrote that. So I split that up similarly and got the same. But there's plus one more tile. One minus half is just a half. So the white tiles, see, there's one more white tile than black tile. Okay then, so I think we've faffed around enough with this one and talked about it to death. So hopefully you've seen that, the idea that was behind it, the question. And I think we're reasonably happy with the answers as well that we've put down. Okay, I think that's that page done then. Let's have a look at what page we're on. 19. Okay, good. Let's go on to the next one.